No, just the capital A.
Mechalkel chayim bechesed, mechayei kol chay v'rachamim rabim, tzohomech noflim v'rofe cholim, u'matir asurim, u'mkayem emunato lishenei afar, lishenei afar. Mi chamocha ba'al gevurot, umi domer lach. Melech mimita umechaye, umatzmiach Yeshua. V'ne'eman atalachayot kochai, baruch ata Adonai, mechaye kochai. 303. Dir vechazak mashmin kol min nasim liumat zrafim liumatam baruch yomeru baruch kevod Adonai mim komo. Mim kom chamalkeinu tofi havetim loch aleinu ki mechakim anachnu. Matai, matai, timloch betzion. Matai, matai, timloch betzion. Bekarov beyamenu leolam vaed tishkom. Tit gadal vetit kadash betoch Yerushalayim mircha ledor vador ledor vador unetzach netzachim ve'enenu tirena tirena machutecha. Kadavar ha'amor v'shirei uzecha ve'enenu tirena tirena mafutecha. Kadavar ha'amor v'shirei uzecha. Imloch Adonai leolam, Elohayich Tzion, ledor vador, Alleluia. Ledor vador, ledor vador, ledor vador, nagid God lecha, ledor vador, ledor vador. Dor vador nagid god lecha ulenetzach netzachim kedushat hanakdish kedushat hanakdish veshivchacha Eloheinu mipinu lo yamush lo yamush leolam vaed. Dor vador, dor vador, dor vador nagid god lecha, ledor vador, ledor vador, ledor vador nagid god lecha, ki el ruach gadol vekadosh ata, gadol vekadosh ata, Ki el ruach gadol vekadosh ata, gadol vekadosh ata. Baruch ata Adonai ha'el ha'kadosh. Continuing on our own, 306 through 323. Or the promptings of our mind or heart. Bottom of 323. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable unto you, O Rabbi. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable unto you, O Rai. Ose shalom, Ose shalom bimromav, Uya ase shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael ve'tevel, ve'imru amen. Osa shalom bimromeha, ita ase shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael ve'tevel, ve'imru amen. Good Shabbos. Good Shabbos. For those in the room, we're going to need a few volunteers as we transition to the Torah service. Folks who want to be close enough to the Torah to hold it. One at the beginning, or actually two couples are welcome, or two, any two, at the beginning and again at the end, as well as Hagba and Glila. Let's do Hagba first, who's feeling strong-armed. Yes. Thank you, Lisa. And Glila to tie it up? Tom, love it. Okay, this is how it should be. The Aliyot are spoken for, but Ark opening in a moment. George, would you like to join?
Yes.
Okay. Huh? No, I'm looking at the lovely lady next to you. Would you like to join? We can have two up here, but no. Okay, great. And at the end, Ark closing, opening and closing. Anyone? Matt, thank you. Okay, excellent. Thank you. A lot to look forward to. I want to wish a refuah shlema to Cheryl Hurwitz, who might have been our davener this morning, and appreciation to all of the Moshavah-connected daveners who I had invited in honor of a Mosh alum and friend and colleague who will be enlightening us a little bit later at the end in the Musaf, Rabbi Toba Spitzer, joining us from our sister shul in Newton, Massachusetts, and always a thrill. And they were all spoken for, so you got my scratchy voice. But we are now in the communal pieces, and we are looking forward to it. So, you guys are actually going to be much later. Ein kamocha Elohim Adonai, ein kemaasecha machutecha machut kol olamim, u'memshaltecha bechol dor vador. Adonai melech, Adonai malach, Adonai imloch leolam. Adonai oz le'amo yiten, Adonai yivarech et amo v'shalom. Yerushalayim, tivne chomot, Yerushalayim, ki vecha levad batachnu, ruach el ram v'nisa, adon olam. 385 at the bottom. Pitru li share tzedek avovam odeya. Pitru li share tzedek avovam. Odeya ze ashar ladonai tzadikim yavovo So the COVID advisory group has, and I'm looking at Bob here with appreciation, I don't think has officially said that we are resuming the walking around and being in face, but is that true or?
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to keep it parked up here, but get a good look. You know what? I'm gonna just kind of walk it around the front a little bit, you know, bend but not break. So page 393. Okay, in that case, could I ask a favor? Would you come up here and just pan this around so that everyone on Zoom can partake, right? So, thank you, Shelley. It'll be easy. Okay. So, just
kind of easy,
right? Just have it face where George and I are.
Okay.
Page 393, Rabbi George will lead. And we respond.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai.
Echad
Eloheinu, Gadol Adoneinu, Kadosh Shmo.
Gadol Adonai, Uyirano, Shmo Yachdav, Lecha Adonai HaGedolah.
Shabbos, everyone. Wow, that's been a very long time.
Yes.
I forgot how winding it is. Okay. feels good to have the Torah up close and personal?
Yes.
Right. I feel like that should be followed up with some traditionally rabbinic thing like, so live it now, people. Right. But what I would say in the more Reconstructionist vein is, make it yours. Okay. Speaking of Parshat Pinchas, named for, of course, the Zealot,
who in the previous parsha at the end stabbed a man and a woman together at what might have been a flagrant in your face violation of social norms, or might have actually been a sort of, because there's so much confusion between Moab and Midian, and there's essentially genocide that is authorized by Moses in the middle of all this with confusion between Moab and Midian. We don't even remember who the enemy is when we get so worked up. And we forget that Midian is where Moses's wife and father-in-law, Yitro, where the Ten Commandments are from, right? It comes from. Somehow Midian went from being our best friend and advisor to our enemy, and we're not even sure that they meant it, because the book at the end of Numbers moves back and forth. There's something very painful in this ultra-nationalism that says, if your name starts with M, right, or with anything but Yud, it's just us. Make Yisrael great again. And we see the toxic results of this, both the genocide that kills the Midianites or the Moabites, the plague that kills so many Israelites, and starting with the two, Cosby and Zimri, who are stabbed by Pinchas. At the very beginning here, Pinchas receives from God Briti Shalom, my covenant of peace, which is counterintuitive until you think, wow, what a beautiful frame for actual rehabilitation and not just incarceration. What do you do with someone who has those violent tendencies, who has been radicalized to be willing to take up arms against the national legal structure in the name of what they think is right? They need to mellow. They need to be deprogrammed and back into the mainstream of life. Thus, the covenant of peace, perhaps. All of that is in the title. Where we pick up, if you have a Chumash in front of you, we are in Numbers chapter 26, verse 52, one of the longest chapters in Torah. Don't ask why. The Masoretes did it in the 8th century, and we never looked back. We are on page 1078 in the new edition of the Plaut, or 1202 in the old. Again, in any pagination, including safaria.org, if you are online, Numbers chapter 26, verse 52. God spoke to Moses saying, oh, important, one line above it. This is the enrollment of the Israelites. After the roll call, tribe by tribe is numbered, 601,730. We always talk about the 600,000. I feel really bad for that 1,730. Like, what are they, bubkis? So, obviously these numbers are written down far later. Take them with a healthy grain of salt. But here's where we get the famous 600,000 from. God spoke to Moses saying, among these, and the commentators have a field day with who are these, shall the land be apportioned as shares according to the listed names. We are now in land allocation territory. With larger groups, increase the share. With smaller groups, reduce the share. Each is to be assigned its share according to its enrollment. How's this striking us so far? On the sort of fair to not fair continuum. Right. Seems incredibly fair. They're even noting that there's a fluctuation of about 20% of population between the larger and the smaller of the tribes. And so the land is according. And there's something kind of cool about that.
But there's no women.
Thank you, Rain, for anyone who didn't hear. But there's no women. And we're getting there. So you're right there ahead of the curve. Thank you. The land, moreover, is to be apportioned by lot, and the allotment shall be made according to the listings of their ancestral tribes. Each portion shall be assigned by lot. whether for larger or smaller groups. On the fair, not fair continuum, right? So not only are we doing it proportionate to population, so that if the numbers work out, everyone gets their 40 acres and a mule, or maybe it's 38 or 42, right? But we're also making sure that it is random, or as the commentaries note, it's with Urim and Tumim, divine divination, so that it is extra fair, right? It is God in charge of this lottery. No one is going to claim lot fraud after this one, right? And try to storm the border. So this is the story that is received about how the tribal lands got their name. These are still around. In modern Israel, when you talk about the Tel Aviv metro region, the statistical metropolitan area, you call it Gush Dan, because there's a mythic memory that 3,200 years ago, the tribe of Dan settled in the Shvelah, the area around Ben Gurion Airport, leading down toward Tel Aviv, and maybe at some point they actually held the entire coast from the Philistines, unclear. We call it Gush Dan. These memories last. Of course, we are the Jews, the Yehudas, the Yahuds, because it was Yehuda who had the tribal land that included Jerusalem, which is both the capital, but also all that was left by the year 701 BCE, thanks to the Assyrians. So these connections go deep. There's a commentary, this is Rashi on this line, just to give a quick flavor and then a quick problematic, and then we're just going to go into the Torah service because we actually have a lot of celebrating to do, but it is a complexity we need to grapple with, how this land got apportioned. To the numerous, thou shalt give more inheritance. This is Rashi in the 1100s. Channeling earlier Midrash. To the tribe that had a numerous population, they gave a large portion of land, although the portions were not of equal area, because as we've already said, in all cases, they assigned the portions according to the size of the tribe, yet they did so only by aid of the lot, and the lot fell by the utterance of the Holy Spirit, as explained in the Talmud, Bava Batra 122a. Eleazar the priest was clothed with the Urim and Tumim and spake by the Holy Spirit. If such and such a tribe comes up, such and such a territory shall come up with him. The names of the tribes were written on 12 tablets, and those of 12 districts on 12 tablets. They mixed them in an urn, and the prince of a tribe inserted his hand in it, as the little metal cage goes around and around. It doesn't actually say that part. All right, and took out 2 tablets. And see me in the morning. There came up in his hand the tablet bearing the name of the tribe and the tablet relating to the district that had been declared. This incredible matching system. This is the lotto, right? Kind of remarkable. So the question here is, who's missing from the narrative? And Rain reminds us one very important thing, that the populations that are enumerated above are the males, the adult males only.
One important
thing. Okay, thank you. Is it Sarah here? Sarah Bar Asher? Right. The vast majority of women are uncounted. And this is what leads a little further down the page. We're not actually reading this section today, but they come up here and again next week in Parshat Maaseh at the very end. The final story of the whole book of Numbers is a reiteration of how right the daughters of Tzlafchad were. And Noah and Chogla and Malka, right? Say their names. They're not just the daughters of Tzlafchad. Don't remember them by that guy, right? Remember them as 5 amazing women who helped shape history. If you read closely next week, we'll see that actually the patriarchy reasserts itself, and they don't quite get the bennies that they seem promised here, because that's the story of history. We establish a Voting Rights Act, and then we nibble away at it at the Supreme Court. And then, halavai, we re-enfranchise more broadly. This is our history, the Jewish history, the American history. So the women are missing, they're gonna come up here. Who else is missing when the land is thusly apportioned? Thank you. The indigenous peoples. John Locke, who Thomas Jefferson channeled, right, famously wrote of life, liberty, and property. And Jefferson had the good sense to not be quite that materialistic when he wrote those important words and became Pursuit of Happiness. But the property theme is still core to this story. John Locke wrote of this new lands being colonized under the crown and said, because these savages have no notion of personal property, there can be no such thing as dispossession of that which they never understood that they owned. The very beginning of the discovery doctrine, the very beginning of manifest destiny, the very beginning of the idea of going into an unsettled land, or as a different narrative, both in Torah and in American history, says, a land where the savage natives don't deserve it anymore. We are more deserving. We will take it by might because we have the right. And that made a great deal of sense for many Israelites and many Americans for many generations. Needless to say, we are reckoning with a messy past. I'm especially interested in this because unspoken when we talk about Shemitah and Yovel, which come up particularly in Leviticus 25, but are scattered throughout the Torah, references to this time when you go back to your ancestral holdings. That only works, and it's rarely talked about even in Shemitah circles, it only works if the original lot is fair. Then it's brilliant. We press a hard reset button every 50 years, a soft reset every 7. It's the best synthesis of capitalism and cooperativism. And right, we get to do our own thing. Some get ahead, some get behind, and then we even things out, and then and so it goes every 7 and then every 50, back to where it was. If where it was fair, golden. If where it was never was fair. These are questions to think about. On 4th of July weekend, on the Parsha, when we read how our ancestors approached this, and at the less than 3-month mark until we start the next Shemitah year, this Rosh Hashanah. All of these are questions. As we think about the history of the land that we were on, which was Nacochink, Piscataway, and which then was tilled by chattel slaves. And don't forget, that wasn't until 1862, that was until 1863 into 64, because Maryland was a border state, but a southern state. This very land, the land on which our houses are built, the land on which this beautiful edifice is built. If we don't complexify, we don't deserve. Does that mean we give it all back? No. Does that mean that some reckoning and some reparation is called for? You decide. Shabbat Shalom. So,
our life is Zoom.
Yes, we are going to try something new. And I need to make sure the volume on this machine is up. Is it? Right. Carol, can you speak? Unmute?
Yes.
Beautiful. We're going to try this. So our first reader is coming forward. Thank you, Bob. And we are where we were looking at verse 52. Nun bet. At the bottom of page 1202 in the Old Plaut, or the middle of 1078. Sorry, middle of 1078 in the new, 1202 in the old. Okay, Carol, take it away.
Baruch et Adonai Hamvora. Baruch Adonai Hamvarath Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Halom Asher Kervanu La'avodato V'natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Atah Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen.
Amen.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech haolam Asher natan lanu Torah emet V'chaye olam nata betoheinu Baruch atah Adonai Notein haTorah.
Amen. Yasher koach to Chaya Sasha Bat Sara VeYitzchak. Would you like to share something with the Kahal?
Yes, I was supposed to be there today, but I'm too jittery from a strong stir right I'm on. I have multiple myeloma, which is a cancer of the blood, of the bone marrow. And I'm okay now, I'm on chemo. September will be a very hard month for me because I'm gonna have a stem cell transplant. So you guys won't see me much, if at all, after that happens for a few months. My immune system will be totally compromised. But right now, except for my voice and my jitteriness, I'm doing okay. And just wanted to share that.
And we are honored that you did. Thank you for sharing your truth and letting us know, and you will keep us posted on how we can support you. Refuah Shlema.
Thank you. Thank you, Rabbi Fred.
Thank you so much for joining. Yasher Koach. This is what it means to be a community. When our beloveds have this news, it needs to be shared. And I thank Carol for coming forward with it. I thank you for sitting with the heaviness, but it's heavy because there's love behind it. And we will be in touch. Mwah. Refuah Shlema. And on to happier milestones, calling Florida / Upper Northwest DC. Ye'amdu Riva Esther bat Liba v'Natan v'Shalom Elazar ben Gittel v'Yaakov la'aliyah shenit. Thank you.
We are picking up at the paragraph break, top of 1203 or middle of 1078, verse 57, Nun Zion.
משפחת הלוי, משפחת החברוני, משפחת המחלי, משפחת המושי, משפחת הקרחי, משפחת הקרחי, וקהת הולי את אמרם, בשם אשת אמרם, יוכבת בת לוי, אשר ילדה אותה ללוי במצרים, ותלד אמרם את אהרון ואת משה ואת מרים אחותם, ויבלל אהרון את נדב ואת אביהו, את אלעזר ואת איתמר, ויעמד נדב ואביהו בהקריבם אש זרה לפני אדוני, ויהיו פקודיהם 23,000 כל זכר מבין חודש ומעלה, כי לא הפקדו בתוך בני ישראל, כי לא ניתן להם נחלה בתוך בני ישראל.
Amen. Yasher koach to Ken, thank you. And yasher koach to the folks with the Aliyah. There was a wonderful anniversary celebrated last week on this theme of Vicky and Joel hitting the magic number of 55. They call this the speed limit, but you're going to keep going. And I understand there's a wonderful crop of 55 years, and I'm seeing Rosalie and Alan for the first time with my own eyes in eons. And right, you're in the cohort. And there was at least one more.
Hmm? The burgers.
Oh, wait a minute. Got my numbers mixed up. Sorry. They're already way past the speed limit, with apologies. 63 is the number. Right. 55 is coming up, hold that thought. Sorry for the confusion. Nebuch, right. 63 years together. Some amazing kids and grandkids, and some amazing work in the world with individuals, with government, with community. What an honor to have you celebrate this amazing milestone. Please, okay. Yeah,
well,
step a little this way.
This is the first time.
Stand one step to the left.
Oops, there. I'm on candid camera. This is the first time in about 2 years that Carol and I have been back into our spiritual home, and it's a spiritual renewal to come back. And the 63rd anniversary, as all our anniversaries in a sense, is the renewal of our love for each other and our hopes for the future, and our hopes for the country's future, which we are hoping more than ever, as you all are. So we're delighted to see you all, and absolutely thrilled to be back to Adat Shalom, and thrilled to be with my beautiful bride.
He robbed the cradle.
It was a big cradle.
Beautiful to have you celebrate here. Enjoy the view, and you all enjoy the view. Mazal tov. Okay. Thank you. Feel free to be seated. We're dispensing with a lot of right. These are sort of leftover COVID protocols that we'll be rethinking week to week. Yasher koach and mazel tov. A moment for the Mishaberach Lecholim, as we again invoke Carol and so many in our hearts and minds. If you are online, feel free to type names into the chat. And if you are here, we're just going to ask to stand in your place. If you're comfortable, grab the shoulder of someone near you. If not, no worries. We are all connected, at least metaphorically, as we say the name and names aloud, just as one sacred cacophony of those we lift up for healing. Ella, Ellie, Stu, Carol, Anabat, Nina, and so many. Mekor habracha meimotenu, may the source of strength who blessed the ones before us help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing. Drive 55. Ye'amdu bat Yechana bat Chaim v'malka ve'Yitzchak Shlomo ben Ephraim Yosef v'Chatya Malka la'aliyah shlishi.
Exactly.
There's no after. So we are fast forwarding now to the end of Numbers 29. These are familiar passages because all those holiday things. Thank you. So that is perfect. Okay. The very end, this is after all the holiday stuff, the maftirs we often do for Shabbat, Rosh Chodesh, and festivals are here in Numbers 28 and 29. Pinchas is a real grab bag parsha. So here we are at the tail end with only one more week of the Book of Numbers to go. Page 1214 at the bottom in the Old Plout or 1086 in the New.
What verse?
Numbers chapter 29, verse 35.
Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kivanu Avodato V'natan Lanu Et Torato Baruch Adonai Notein HaTorah. Vayom Hashmini Atzeret Yalachem Kol Melech Avodah Lo Tosu V'kravtem Olah Isher yanicho achvadunai, parachad ayelachad, kevasim b'nei shana, shivat mimim, minchatam v'nizkehem. Lapor lo ayil lakvasim, b'misparam kamishpat, usir chatat echad, milvad olat hatamid, uminchatav v'nizkehem. Ele tasu ladonai b'mawadechem levad minidrechem v'nidvotechem lolotechem ulminchotechem ulnizkechem ulshalmechem v'yome moshel b'nei Yisrael kechol asher tziva adonai
et moshel.
Eloheinu melech haolam, asher natan lanu torat emet, v'chaye olam nata b'tocheinu, baruch atah Adonai, notein ha-torah.
Amen.
So, back to the palindrome, the first palindrome past mid-century, with an amazing club that you are joining. The anniversary itself is
today.
Wow, fantastic. So we are thrilled. And again, what a difference to have made with such incredible progeny and with such incredible legacy in the Kahal and in the nation, in the Jewish people. Thank you for all that you have done, and yashar koach on all that you will yet do.
Thank you.
Happy anniversary.
Thank
mazel.
You.
Mazel. Mazel tov.
This is our first time back here in the sanctuary in about 2 years. You know, last year. Well, last year we were in November. Yeah, I guess it was November of 2019, and then we were in Florida, and we got stuck down there, came back here, and we're back in Florida in the winter, but now we're back here with the community, and we're really glad to be here, and we're glad all of you are here, too. And it's 63 and 67.
Awesome.
Well, wow.
Some great numbers.
Yes.
Awesome. Yashar koach, thank you. Thrilled to have you with us. Thanks.
Okay.
Perfect. Okay. So time to lift and wrap. Ya'amod hamagnia ta'amod hagolalet.
Torah, 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 Torah,
Ziva Lanu Moshe.
Thank you, Shelley. Yasher Koach. Matot Masse coming up with a Chazak Chazak Venit Chazek next week, along with already getting close to announcing, believe it or not, that late summer month of Av, with Tisha B'Av coming up. So next week, wait a minute, that means that, does anyone know what day Rosh Chodesh actually is? It is on Shabbat next week, which means that we actually announce it here. Thank you, needed that. So Rosh Chodesh Av, with the 9 days of mourning, we are already in the 3 weeks of Azhara. And if we were reading the traditional Haftarah today, it would be one of those passages from early Isaiah or Jeremiah with the wagging finger of warning that the people's iniquities are so great that major dislocation lies ahead because they have not done national tshuva. Something incredibly powerful about that on July 4th weekend, and this question of history of land and reparation and restoration. So the wagging finger is there, perhaps simply as metaphor or historical instruction, or perhaps as azhara, as warning for us as well. Next week, the Shabbat that is Rosh Chodesh, and the week after that, we will, in the morning, be davening, and in the evening, gathering for Erev Tisha B'Av, July 17th. Yes, it's early on the solar calendar this year. Just acknowledge it, and we move on. So, on page six, Rosh Chodesh. Oh, that's why it's still in the fours, of course. We're out of practice, right? Page 425, inviting us to rise. I believe Av is a 2 day, right? So that it's Friday and Saturday, right? Okay. So page 425, rise as we are able. Yehi ratzon lufanecha Adonai Eloheinu v'lo avoteinu v'imateinu shetechadesh aleinu et hachodesh hazeh letova v'livracha v'titen lanu chayim harukim chayim shel shalom chayim shel tova chayim shel bracha chayim shel mazon ufarnasah chayim shel chilutz atzamot Chaim sheyesh bahem ahava ve'yirat shamayim. Chaim she'en bahem busha uchlima. Chaim shel osher ve'chavod. Chaim sheyesh bahem yosher utvuna ve'haskel ve'deha. Chaim she'imalu mishalot libeinu letova. Amen. Misha asani sim labatinu limatinu vega'al otam avdu lecherut hu yigal otanu bekarov vikabetz minachinu ve'abakan fotaretz chaverim kol Yisrael ve'nomar amen. There's no good songs to go with Av, but there's the blues. Keep it going. Na 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 na. Rosh Chodesh Av. Na 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 na.
יהיה ביום השישי. ויהיה ביום השבת הבא עלינו ועל כל ישראל לטובה. יחד שהוא הקדוש ברוך הוא עלינו ועל כל יושבי תבל לחיים ולשלום, אמן. לששון ולשמחה, לישועה ולנחמה, ונאמר אמן. Page 441, and Matt will open the ark, and we are ready to place the Torah. Do you do the other side? Thank you. ובנו כל יום, שיבר עני רבות עתה ישראל, כי לך טוב נחתי לכם, תורתי אל תעזוב. עץ חיים space that we call Musaf, the extra offerings, the reprises, the underlining of key themes of the morning, or simply a celebration in song with the people who happen to be in the room or on the Zoom. And we are thrilled to have back in the room friend, colleague, teacher, movement leader, amazing human being, and Camp Moshava alum, among many other key identifiers, and Somerset native, home visiting mom, unfortunately, on the occasion of her aunt's passing, thrilled to have Toba with us, Rabbi Toba Spitzer. We have a commitment that she will be back on her book tour next year on metaphorical theology. It is going to be the most important book on modern theology written since Mordechai Kaplan. You heard it here, probably 30.
But no high expectations or anything like that.
Whatsoever.
And a lot more readable. I mean, I don't know if it'll be as good, but it'll certainly be more readable. I love Mordechai Kaplan, please. But no aspersions on my teacher, Rabbi Mordechai Kaplan. So Rabbi Fred invited me to do a little music with y'all. I wanted to do two songs. He said sometimes you revisit Psalms from Sukkah to Zimra. So I wanted to do a version, and I want you to sing with me, hopefully. I don't know if you all do this. Do you do Yosef Karduner's Essayna?
Yes.
You do?
Awesome. I almost did it this morning.
Beautiful. So we're going to, so good. You guys know it. So it's on page 215 in the Siddur. There's a lot of, he does a lot of the words that aren't transliterated. So I do some of that as Yai Dai Dai. So yeah, the top of 215.
Shile ma'alo esa einai el harim
Me'ayin yavo Ezri, Ezri me'im Adonai, Ose shamayim va'aretz, Al yitein lamod raglecha, Al yanum shomrecha. Yai dai dai dai, dai 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 Se shamayim va'aretz ha'yitein lamod raglecha al yanum shomrecha yai dai 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 yai dai 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 Psalm. This is a setting of Psalm 13, which is not in the Siddur, but it's not a lot of words, so I'll tell you what the words are. One of the, I call them COVID blessings, things that were cool about last year, amidst all the stuff that was really not cool, was being able to do stuff not in the Siddur because I could screen share it. I wish we had like a virtual screen share. I could just go, here's the word.
It's a conversation.
Yes. So, so it's two lines from Psalm 13. Va'ani bechastecha batachti. Try that with me. Va'ani bechastecha batachti, which means, and I in your love, this is the psalmist speaking to the divine, and I in your loving kindness, your chesed batachti, trusted. Yagel libi, try that. Yagel libi b'yeshuatecha. Yeshuatecha. So my heart rejoiced in your I call it liberating power. So va'ani b'chastecha b'tachti, yagel libi b'yeshuatecha. My heart was gladdened in you, by your liberating power. And then on the chorus, and that repeats, and then the chorus is Ashir el Adonai. I sing to Adonai, Ashir el Adonai, Ashir el Adonai, ki gamal alai. Which Gamal is completely impossible to translate, but because God's Gamal is used with Chesed, Gimilut Chesedim, because like God was gracious to me, basically. So I sing to God from this sense of bounty. So it goes like this. And again, Yonatan Reizel is the person who set it to music.
It's in the chat.
Yeah. So for you Zoomers, have it in the chat. Thank you, Rabbi Fred.
Va'ani v'chastecha v'tachti Yigel libi v'yeshuatecha Va'ani v'chastecha v'tachti Yigel libi v'yeshuatecha.
I'm going to do a little higher, sorry. Let's try a little higher.
Va'ani v'chastecha v'tachti Yigel libi v'yeshuatecha Va'ani v'chastecha v'tachti Yigel libi v'yeshuatecha Shir el Adonai, Shir el Adonai, Shir el Adonai Gamal alai, Ashir el Adonai, Ashir el Adonai, Ashir el Adonai, Shira la donai, kigamala lai. Ani lechas lecha vatahti, geli bi bishuateta. Ani lechas lecha vatahti, geli bi bishuateta. Shira la donai. Shira la donai, shira la donai, higamahala lai. Shira la donai, shira la donai, shira la donai, higamahala lai. Dai, 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 dai. When I know you, I am free. For in your love I have trusted. When I know you, I am free. Shira la donai, shira la donai, shira la donai, kigamahala lai. Shira la donai, shira la donai.
That's enough, except for an original composition as part of Aleinu. You've heard me quote Toba over the years extensively, often, and we will continue to do so. Sometimes we are quoting words, and sometimes we are quoting melodic notations. The composer of many an original piece of liturgical music, including for that important second stanza of the Aleinu, Shehunoteh Shamayim, the one that we introduced here about 20 years ago, for the first or second time, doing it actually on our
beat.
Yeah, I think you did once before, but it was a ways back. Anyway. Page 445.
But I have to give another introduction to that.
Bevakasha.
Because Miriam's here. I'm sure it was Judith Kaplan Eisenstein, Zichrona Livracha, somewhere I either read or heard her say that the Shehunoteh Shamayim that we sing is basically Itsy Bitsy Spider. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I was like, you're right. I hate it. And now I know why I hate it. So with apologies to anyone who loves that too. But I mean, I love Itsy Bitsy Spider. I just don't like it as part of Aleinu. So I was like, I made it my life mission to erase that from the collective memory of the Jewish people. I think I have failed in that. But
I don't know.
So I tried to write something that was similar but different enough that would take us away from Itsy Bitsy Spider. So that is the provenance. It is a very deep Reconstructionist roots. I wanted to give a shout out to Reb Judith for that, for inspiring that. So yes, please join me. Please rise if you are able in body or in spirit. Top of 445.
Shamayim v'yoser ha'aretz U'moshav yikaro v'ashamayim imahal U'shrin adu zoho v'gof he'meromim Hu Eloheinu einod Emet malkeinu efes ulato Kakatu v'torato V'yadata hayom behashevota el levavecha ki Adonai hu ha'el ha-shamayim imahal, v'al ha-aretz, v'al ha-aretz, mitachat einod. Ha-ken nekevel ha-chadonai. ותקן עולם במלכות שדי ככתוב בתורתך אדוני ימלוך לעולם ועד ונאמר והיה אדוני למלך על כל הארץ ביום ההוא ביום ההוא יהיה אדוני Ushemo, Ushemo, Ushemo.
That would be beautiful. Thank you. Excellent. Okay. We may be seated. Thank you, thank you. We turn to the memory of those who are no longer with us and just looming so large in our collective consciousness, the tragedy in Surfside, Florida this week. Estimated 40 Jews, along with so many, including Israelis and Jews from elsewhere, as well as many Colombians and Venezuelans and other visiting and immigrant Latinx folks, along with just a United Nations in that building. And our hearts are heavy as we remember them and all those who were needlessly lost this week. We are remembering in and inviting, of course, to put in the chat any both recent losses or yard sites that are not named here. We remember as well those, the anniversary of who's there, of their passing having fallen from now through the end of this coming week. Derek Paley's grandfather, Karen's father, Philip Sussman, and Karen's sister, Arlene Lois Moore. Rain Weiner's grandmother and Eileen Dwyer's mother, Anna Fogel. Ann Rosenthal's father, Irving. Mark Feldman's grandmother, Fanny Weiner. Joel Darmstadter's father, Carl, David Cuney's brother, Richard, Jeff Rubin's mother, Celia, Susan Gaeta's mother, Fran Feltman, Michelle Mellinger's great uncle, Samuel Hanverger, Marla Zippin's uncle, Bernard Harris, Harriet Sugarman's stepfather, Sidney Heyman, Hal Siegel's grandmother, Doris Lorber, Myra Patner's mother, Rose Mensch, Steve Major's sister, Denise Schiller, Joanna Seiden's grandmother, Harriet Siegel, Robert Singer's grandfather, Joseph, Elena Broder Feldman's grandmother, Beatrice Broder, Barbara Alpert's parents, Augusta and Joseph Ritterband, Mary Catherine Fish's late husband, Tom Gerline, Betsy Turetsky's grandmother, Beatrice Rudin, Judy Zouderer's mother-in-law, Ethel, Bob Furman's mother, Ruth, Adrian Olick's father, Theodore, Robin Paley's grandmother, Dottie Robinson, and our much-missed Adina Cole's late husband, Noah and Maya Guthman's father, Louis Guthman. Inviting all those who are in mourning or commemorating a yard site to please rise as we also add to the list Toba's aunt.
My aunt and my mother's sister, Marilyn Wisoff. So page 451. Yitgadal v'yitgadash shemei rabba. V'yalma divrach yirutei v'yamlich machutei b'chayeichon uv'yomeichon uv'chayei dochol beit Yisrael. Bagala uvizman kariv imru. Amen. Yehi shmei rabba mevorach leolam ualmei almaya. Yitbarach, v'yishtabach, v'yitpa'ar, v'yitramam, v'yitnaseh, v'yithadar, v'yitaleh, v'yithalal, shmed, gurusha, brechu, le'ela, min kol berchata, v'shirata, tushbachata, v'nechamata, damiran b'yalma, v'imru, amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya, v'chaim aleinu, v'yalkol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. Usei shalom b'mromav, hu ya'aseh shalom, aleinu, v'yalkol Yisrael, v'yalkol yoshvei tevel, v'imru, amen.
Zichronam livracha, all of their memories for a blessing. Thank you again, Toba. Thank you, all the Torah readers and participants, and enormous appreciation to Carol Stern in the back, the Gabbai of Gabbais. thank you. And anyone else who helped out on Zoom as well, please keep the comments coming. We are still experimenting with how to do hybrid well. We have almost exactly the same. I'm counting about 50 in the room and about 50, maybe a little more with couples on Zoom. So we are nicely balanced between Zoomies and Roomies today, a minion of minions together, and thrilled to have all of you with us. And glad you're all here. So in a moment, we will get to schmooze over wine and grape juice as we linger. And the group here, I don't believe that we're breaking out, but everyone who wants to stay together will do so. And just be conscious of how many people are on the screen and take the appropriate amount of time and space. Oh, you are breaking out. Great. Okay. So into a handful of groups and still be mindful. So excellent. I love the hybrid, says Ruth. Thank you. Let's hear it for hybrid, says Barb. Thank you. Yay. Okay. Glad it's working. We want to keep it working as well as possible. And we are in process. So a few quick reminders and then a closing song. And we wish you Shabbat Shalom. Who's the board greeter? Thank you. We are honored to have our treasurer, Jesse, join us for a word of greeting.
Certainly Shabbat Shalom to everybody here in the room and everybody not in the room, but also very much here in the room, Tier. And certainly our thank you, Carol, for sharing your news and congratulations to our honorees. So so exciting to be together so long. And it's so wonderful to see people in person and even faces, because we're all project to that. And I do want to remind you to sign up in advance for attending Shabbat in person, because the word is if we don't have 10 people, we don't have a minion, then we will just hold it on Zoom and not in person. So you just can't scooch it at the last minute. So you got to think at the beginning of the week to sign up. And to remind everybody about the Honey from the Heart opportunity to send sweetness to those you love, those you like, those you want to remember you. And they get the honey, they get the recognition, and yes, the Dutch Loan gets a little bit of cash. It's a little bit of fundraiser. So please think about it. The deadline to send the honey without having to pay for postage is July 7th. So that's very soon. So not today, but tomorrow or the next day.
That's the bike ride tomorrow.
Oh, and Matt wanted to remind that there's a bike ride, a group of people, we've got over a million, assembling in downtown Bethesda to ride towards the Supreme Court and back, an estimated 22 miles, but spread out over a couple hours. So please join us for that and reach out to Matt if you have questions. So that's it. Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Great to see you.
Thank you so much. Say something about voting rights when you get to those marble steps. But what a wonderful, wonderful ride. And ride safely, travel safely, drive safely, fly safely for some people for the first time in eons. As we take these little baby steps back towards something that approximates normal and try to do it better than we did it before, with greater intentionality, with more justice and consciousness of each other and of sustainability. May we ease into this second half of the year and celebrate the fourth. in many cases together with loved ones. Special shout out to the many Adat Shalom kids and others who are at camp this Shabbat, be it the many at Camp Havaya, the sizable number at Camp Moshava, at Eden Village, and others scattered across so many, from Capital Camps in Louise and Erie to Ramah and the Union Camps and the Young Judea and the other Habonim and the BBYO, and I know I'm leaving some out, but you get the picture. So just sending those blessings for the multi-generational ality that is not necessarily Zoom or Room today, but there's a lot of Adat Shalom youngsters praying this morning in their own special sacred spaces. Page 459. Sidur went away. I think I have it memorized. We'll see, with a special adaptation for the fourth. Oh, thank you so much. This is what should be our national anthem, because it was written by a woman, because it is not born of battle and militarism and does not use such archaic language, but speaks to some very important themes. So we're going to open with the second stanza of America the Beautiful and continue into Adon Olam, 459. Four fifty-nine. But first, oh, beautiful for pilgrim feet whose stern impassioned stress, a thoroughfare for freedom beat across the wilderness, America. America, God mend thine every flaw. Affirm thy soul with self-control, thy liberty in law. Adon Olam Asher Malach B'terem kol yitzir nivra, le'ed nasa b'chefso kol, azay melech shemo nikra, ve'acharei kichlot hakol, levado yimloch nora, ve'hu haya, Vehu hove, vehu yiye betifara, vehu echad, ve'ein sheni, lahamshilo lehachbira, beli reshit, beli tachlit, velo haoz vehamisra, Vehu eli vechai goali vetzur chevli beetzara Vehu nisi umanosli menat kosi beyomekra Beyado afkid ruchi Be'et ishan ve'aira ve'im ruchi gevi'ati Adonai li ve'lo ira America, chol yoshvei tevel, God shed God's grace on thee and crown thy good with siblinghood from sea to shining sea. Good Shabbos, good Shabbos. Stick around and greet, stick around and greet. Shabbat Shalom. Oh. Kiddush. Good point. Page 465. Rise as you are able.
Ken Baruch Adonai Meshavat Ve'ikad Shehu Savri Chaverai. Amen. Baruch Adonai Elohim Ruach Olam Borei Pri HaGafen. Baruch Adonai Elohim Ruach Olam Motzi Lechem Min Haaretz Peteach Bo.
Thank you. Shabbat Shalom.
Charlotte, do you want to join a room? I will make sure you can get into one. Let me see. Where are you? You have to click on the join. There you go. Shulamit, do you want to join a room? Okay.
Thank you. Yeah. I would have, but I would. I know. Yeah. What I know. Yeah. And it seems never not. I mean, I. Good.
Thank you. I Next part is the latest, but on Columbine.
Yeah.
That's all of our many meetings. Thank you.
That was your first in this whole time?
Yeah.
Come with me for just a moment. I needed to see if there's anyone still on.
I was just thinking. Maybe we need a giant screen so that we can see the Zoom.
We are actively discussing that, yes. So, all right. Hold on 1 second.
And what's happening for the high holidays? Has that been determined?
We think we're going to do the same hybrid, except there'll be more cameras and better, so it'll be like a professional setup. And let's see, close all the rooms. Here we go. Okay. So there'll be a number of people here. We don't know if we're going to set an upper limit, but we'll see. Yeah. How are the kids?
Good. Yeah, I just talked to Michelle a long time yesterday.
Oh, good.
So we're actually planning a vacation in North Carolina, July 31st.
Oh, wonderful.
And Michelle is going to meet us. We're in North Carolina. Michelle's going to meet us. So that'll be our vacation.
That is lovely. Wow. So I'm glad you're getting out and she's getting out.
It's still working from home.
Right.
Maybe after Labor Day, I might be working in the office. Who knows?
Right. It's great that you can. Awesome.
And Cheryl Wilson working.
No, I'm so glad that works and that you've got all that time. So, all right. Blessings. Thanks. Hey, can folks hear me? Shabbat Shalom. I am not Carol, but she asked me to close things up. Anyone want to check in as a whole? Are you able to unmute yourselves? Someone test? No? Okay, hold up. Security participants may unmute themselves. Try it now. Everyone unmute and say Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. How they can hear you.
So, hey, Gary and Jan.
Hey.
Hi, Nana.
We'll be seeing you shortly. Hi, Marilyn.
Hi.
You're left.
Hi.
Hi, Vita.
Hi. Shabbat Shalom.
Hi, Carol.
Hi. Marilyn, you and I have to talk about Pam Fessler.
Okay, but I think we're getting...
You can tell me later.
Okay.
But I want to say that Ina and I have a date for second day Rosh Hashanah services in person.
Oh my gosh, that's wonderful.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you. I'm so glad to hear that.
What was that? Say that again, Carol.
Ina and I have a date to go in person to the second day Rosh Hashanah services.
She's going to open up the doors for me. Okay.
Sorry, what, Annabelle?
She's going to open up the doors for me unless you get the door openers, the automatic door openers fixed by them.
Are they going to be fixed?
But we are working on it. It is a long list. It was an old building needing a lot of work before the pandemic and then it atrophied. But yeah. Awesome. That is, Carol, thank you. And Annabelle, can't wait to hug or elbow bump or whatever it is we're doing at that point. So a funny story that the helpers and the Sherlanders will appreciate, but I think you all will. So Toba, this dear friend and colleague, was a Habonim Moshe person. And turns out that her, from when she did the gap year in Israel called workshop, that she was, where by the way, she knew Ellie, our like Miss Ellie, who Ellie shook with Moses. And there was a whole circle of people like that. It turns out that the kibbutz parents who like took her under wing for months of that year, it was Bruce Kutnick's brother. So just like we discovered via Gary that the Kutniks and the helpers are cousins, that here Toba runs into Bruce and Malka and like Kutnick, huh? And
really? Wow.
So it's
a small Jewish world.
Exactly.
What was the other cousins you were talking about, the helpers and who?
Oh, Gary's related to Malka.
Oh, is Pope, was Toba Spitzer ever in Verbrengen? Were we trying to rack our brains for that?
He was in the Verbrengen Cheder. She wasn't.
He was in the Cheder. Okay.
And in that community, she went to Verbrengen a few times with
them.
Her community. But yes, Verbrengen Cheder, and they're close with David Schneer, who led the funeral this past week for right, and I helped with a shiva, so we're like keeping it in the family. So
I need to write down the telephone number for you for the second day of Rosh Hashanah so we can be in touch.
That's a fine
my phone number?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, you ready?
Well, that doesn't mean I'm ready. Okay, go ahead.
6343.
Oh, that's so sweet of
you,
Carol.
Okay.
How are you?
6343.
How are you, Vita?
I'm fine.
Good.
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 How wonderful.
Rabbi Fred. Rabbi Fred, your mother's calling. One sec.
Hey. Oh, I'm sorry, Elizabeth, with the Kiddush Cup stuff. So I didn't bring it up.
Thank you. That's right. I had seen it and then I saw Steve and I wanted to acknowledge the person.
Rita asked me to do it and Elizabeth said I did it. I said, great.
You're right. Thank you. So there's one.
There is one with a plastic cup.
Do you want a serving? All right. I'll take it. Thank you. Best all around. Okay. Hi.
Hi. We have a request for our breakout group and it is, please ask Fred to continue these breakout sessions because they're wonderful.
I agree.
Yes.
Yeah.
You mean after COVID, after all the Zooming, how we do that?
As long as
we mean breakout in the Kiddush, during Kiddush.
Yeah. Or it wasn't during, I waited till after Kiddush. But I think we should continue doing them for those who can't join.
I agree.
I heard
that the idea was to be like a group of the whole schmoozing.
It doesn't work.
But it would be too many. I'm glad this worked. There were six rooms, it looks like. That's probably a good size. Were all of your groups like in that sweet spot of like 4 to 6?
We had three people, but.
Did you say you had 7, Gary?
No, we had 4.
Oh. We had 7. Okay.
Thank you, Jesse.
Sorry.
Yeah. Three screens, right? Maybe. It's so nice and intimate. And when we did the whole shebang before, it just didn't work. Just does not work.
Right.
Even when you're sitting at a table of 8, you're not talking to 8 people at the same time. Like, so 4 is a nice number. Even 6, but bigger than that. There were 50 people, you said? Davening from home?
Yeah, that's what originally it seemed to be, yeah.
That would be insane to dump everybody in one, one spot.
Absolutely. I was wondering if we could do something.